Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to my Blade Warband on Doff TV. My name is Kohath. I'll be your main host tonight. I am joined by, you all know her, we all love her, the lovely Aeronwen from Wales.
Hi.
Hi. How you doing?
I'm fine, thanks for asking me. I'm excited to see this match.
It's good. And, of course, from across the pond, almost at least, across the river maybe, we got Fozzy.
Hello.
Was that it? Just
yes,
a hello.
That's it. That's the grand entrance that I'm making.
Wow.
Just,
I mean, I think I gave you a really good intro here, but
Fozzy did say he was tired, so I guess we're lucky it wasn't a snore.
Yeah, there we go. Exactly.
I mean, that would be a better entrance than hello.
I'm sorry. Roll me in again. I'll come up with something.
All right. You ready? Aeronwen, you should give me a drum roll.
Yeah, I'm not
ready
for that.
All right. Are you ready, Fozzy?
Yes, always.
From England, here is Fozzy!
Hello, everyone. Wow, it's me, Kohath. Fantastic to see you, buddy. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm great. Thank you for asking. I mean, Aeronwen didn't ask, so I mean, you're the only one showing compassion, you know?
Yes. Passion, well known for it, yeah. you didn't give Aeronwen a second try like you gave me, so there we go, that's why.
Well, no, but she was fine the first time, you see.
Yeah, I'm a pro.
She's done this a few times. It's you that I'm a bit worried about. I have to keep looking out for you, you know?
Yeah, that's it. Just any one word sort of answers, just yell at me and I'll do better.
We're here, obviously, to listen to Fozzy, but also to watch the Polish Cup final. I can't pronounce anything in the Polish way, so I hope everybody will forgive me. I'm sure Fozzy will make up for my deficiency.
Thanks. Yes, obviously. Well known for my Polish me.
What do we know about it so far?
Well, funny you ask. I mean, here we have the beautiful statistics. By the way, all images are provided by Dictator. Huge, huge props to him for doing that. Starting off with Polish Eagles, we have they've played 8 matches so far. They've only lost one against Saracens in the league stage. But they did amazing in the quarterfinals and the semifinals, winning 12-1 and 12-2. And then we have the second team.
I think Polish Eagles have got to be the favourites, haven't they? Well, they've played as a team, more as I understand it. I have looked at the Polish forum where all the information is, but unfortunately, surprisingly, my Polish has completely deserted me and I couldn't understand any of it. As far as I'm aware, Polish Eagles have played recently. After all, they played in WMT2 as a team, whereas Saracens, although they all play, and I don't believe they've played as a team very recently until this tournament. So, I mean, they've obviously done remarkably well, so they don't need to have that practice all the time, but it's got to give an edge to Polish Eagles, surely.
To be fair, they're both just such good teams. They've won so many things. I'd agree that Polish Eagles look the strongest side, but I was very surprised to see that Saracens had beaten them. And what, that's only a few matches ago, a few weeks ago, is it that happened? So I don't know if you really can call a favourite just because Saracens beat them before. Oh, personal favourites. Okay. Oh, I don't have one. I like both teams. How boring's that? Oh,
well, I like both teams. I'm saying I dislike anybody. Yeah, yeah. Fair enough.
Also, slight technical issue that apparently I had muted my microphone, but I'm up now so you all can hear my beautiful voice.
How could no one hear you?
Yes, it probably just sounded like you two talking to each other. And like, well, like sometimes it's just no completely quiet.
Yeah, oh, that's good. Luckily someone told us.
Yeah, yeah. That's why we need the chat to be interactive, because we guys read everything.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's good. Does that mean you need to repeat all the information you've just
given? No. I mean, they can decipher it from the two of you talking, okay. Surely.
I'm quite looking forward to seeing who gets 100 kills first, Prince or Sedek.
Oh my.
That's the exciting thing for the first round.
Keep an eye on that. Yeah. Who gets the first kill? First to 100. Unless, of course, it isn't one of those, and Wodge gets 10 kills before they get one.
These two teams have met each other in the past, in the Polish Cup 12 and the Polish Cup 14, where they're both like one each. The Polish Eagles winning 11-8 in the 2012 one, and Saracens winning 9-7 in the 2014 one. Like this is the tiebreaker, you know. Whoever wins this is it.
Yeah, because as we say every tournament, this may be the last
until the next last one. This is the last one.
Okay, I'm just going to point out here that we've had a look at all the servers and the teams. We've just got on the server because the teams have just chosen one. And they've chosen a German server, and it was we're really, really thankful to Script for donating the server for this match. So thanks to him, everybody check out his thread, which we will post at some later time.
Some later time. I like it.
Well, I can't do it now. I'm a bit busy.
All right, we're just waiting for the teams to get ready on the server right now. Saracens seems to be... we have trouble getting enough members. Hopefully that'll fix itself soon. So let's talk a little bit about each teams then. I mean, we talked a little bit about it, but I just wanna, because they didn't hear me earlier, where I said all of my good stuff, you know. So just gotta do a little repeat for you two.
Yeah, go for it. Tell us all the knowledge.
All the knowledge.
All the things.
Yes. So
starting off,
we have the Polish Eagles. They've played 8 matches this season, having an amazing number of 686 kills so far.
Phenomenal.
Yeah. We see that they won almost everyone. They lost against the Saracens in the league stage. So maybe that's like a little bit of a predetermination of how this match will go, because they lost 6-8.
What was that score? 6-8?
Yeah.
6-8, yeah.
So it's very close. Also, they won 12-1 and 12-2 in the quarter and semifinals. I mean, they got some really big names here, like Prince, Wojc, and Hubert. I'm really excited to watch them in action. But then again, we also...
and Harmon. Yeah, but default match.
Yeah, they only got over 600 kills. God, it's like they weren't even trying. It's good to see, just having a look at this, there's a statistics page where it's got all the kills and so on. It's good to see that all the top players seem to be performing really well in the tournament, because there's nothing worse than when that doesn't happen.
Because I done goofed again.
Oh yeah. No, have you muted us now or something?
No, I'm muting myself again.
Again?
Yeah.
Kohath.
It's
whatever that button is, Kohath, keep your hands away.
Yeah.
It's problem fixed.
Just keep
again.
Us when he mutes himself. We'll
again,
try
the amazing chat doing work here. Apparently I went muted in mid-sentence.
At least it wasn't as bad as us just beginning by having an imaginary conversation with a voice that no one else could hear.
I mean, I think that's pretty entertaining in my opinion. just talking to nothing. Gives the viewers a sense of an imagination, like they have to think what the other person is saying. And like they can go completely wild, you know?
Yeah, fill in your own half of the conversation. Yeah.
Just no. Type it out in chat, you know?
Should go through that again then.
Well, the problem is I don't know how far I've gone though.
Yeah, which sentence, William? Which sentence did you mute yourself?
Either way, the screen that's up right now should have all the information I just said. Just that I said it to make it easier for you. I mean, I know it's pretty hard to read, so. That's why we're doing this. We should go live any second. Saracens still have a wee bit of trouble. They have 7 out of 8 right now.
Oh, maps. Are we going to mention the WMT2 admin mod is being used, and it's similar rules to the match, but I'm not entirely sure again. Inability to read Polish is
the affliction you really struggle from, isn't it, Aeronwen? Strikes the worst.
I mean, you are the expert here amongst us. I mean, we look to you for counsel, so just, you know, if you don't know it, then make it up at least. we gotta look professional.
the pick ban system is similar, except the teams also pick the factions. So we don't know the bans, but PE picked Fort of Honor. They'll be playing Vegas versus Nords, and PE pick Vegas, and obviously then Saracens pick Nords. So what do you think of the map? I mean...
Wait, can you... did you say River Village? Saracens versus what?
Vegas.
No, that's a second match.
Oh, okay. I'm just way ahead, I see. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I thought I'd leave us something to talk about.
No, I've just spoiled everything, you see. No, I can't have anything in suspense. Just put it all out there.
Maybe heard you muted yourself again. Yeah. And, they didn't hear anything.
No, I think it's. I don't think that any team has any advantage on either map. Like, both teams got so good names for all classes.
But this is going to be one of those just. Absolute cracking matches, I think.
I think this is more a match of tactics and team play rather than skills. But we'll see.
I'd like to see both teams just first round just charge at each other in an attempt to get their guy to 100 kills first. That's no tactics, just charge, get that glory right now. And then you can do tactics after the first round.
That is, after all, the important thing about this match. Who gets first to 100?
Yeah, obviously.
And they're both on 99, so it's the first kill between the two of them that counts.
Prince with 99 kills, Sebek with 99 kills, yeah. But, I mean,
wouldn't it be great if they did one of those things where they killed
each other?
Well, either way, luckily, Warband shows who died first. So we will have a winner either way. But I think I'm more excited who gets the second to 100 for sure, Mass Effects.
As I say, it's always possible they'll be first.
Yeah, but I mean, they're at 1989. They're almost just as close. That's so amazing that all three top players are so close.
Yeah, but if Hodge gets 10 kills before Prince gets one, then he takes the top spot. First to 100.
I can see that happening, yeah. Definitely.
Well, you know, actually, are they all on the server even? We have faith in
Watch. Oh, yeah, that's a good thing to check. Well, Watch is here. Prince is here. I've got a good, solid team. Polish Eagles here today.
Good, solid team.
We lost a few Saracens.
No,
they're still connecting on the server.
There's seven. We're close. We're close, guys. Just one more.
No, there shouldn't be any doubt, but if you're having trouble displaying who's talking, then there is an overlay in the top left when we go live. I mean, it's pretty hard to distinguish between Aeronwen and Fozzy.
That's so exciting.
Well known for my feminine voice, Lee.
Well, you are, but actually. I didn't want to mention it, but...
If it's quite posh and monotone, it's me. And if it's a lady, then it's Aeronwen. There we go.
Not even mentioning her accent. Just if it's a lady, it's Aeronwen. You know, maybe I'd want to sound like a lady.
Go on. That's my challenge to you, Gareth. This entire stream, you've got to try and convince everybody that, like, so that no one can tell the difference.
Oh, no, I can't do that.
Well, not with that attitude. Come on. I've got belief. We've all got belief in you. I'm sure the comments are going to say, go on it. Do it.
Now come to think of it, Liv told me today that I'm just like a drunk cleric. So.
I don't think that's a compliment.
I was very happy.
As I'm sure is cleric.
Well, at least he got a confirmation that he's a good drunk, you know.
Okay, maybe I won't try for that one.
I think of a better challenge, Fozzy, is if everyone tries to sound like me. You know, put on that hard Norwegian accent. Oh, now she just went quiet.
Yeah, no, I was thinking it over that I decided I couldn't possibly do that. No.
I think that you should try.
About the match. So what do you think on this match then?
Yeah. All right, continue. What about the match?
No, what would you have chosen? If you'd chosen this map, which faction would you have chosen?
Is this the map that we're doing it on, this one now?
Yes.
Yeah, put on a first map, I believe.
Keep in mind, Fozzy, that the people in the stream can't see the map, so you might want to specify, instead of just saying this map, you know.
As anyone who knows me, Kara, will tell you, I don't really operate in map names. I go by, is it that one? Is it the one with the buildings?
Oh, I see. It's just like...
And then steadily run through every single map of a building until I can figure it out. And I'll be honest, about sort of hit and miss, it's about sort of 6 times out of 10 we'll have got it right by the time it actually comes to the map. And then I'm like, oh, it's this one. I know this one. Why didn't someone just say it? I was like, we tried, Fozzy. We tried.
it's just like with how we're doing Dolph, you know, when we're doing directions, like, yeah, you, Kohath, you go over there. Like, where's
yeah,
over there?
Directions. My favourite.
And they're like, yeah, just
Vegas,
that way.
Then. You'd pick Vegas if you were... confident that your archers were going to play a huge part in the map? In the match? On this map?
I guess you have to be. Personally, I'd go for crossbow just because I like them.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Me too, actually.
Maybe sort of Swadia.
But that slow race of fire, though. I mean, surely archers is an advantage on a close map where you want to shoot as fast as possible into the fights.
Depends how much cover you've got and how gung-ho your cover, I suppose.
Yeah, this one's got quite a bit of cover, and, you know, there's corners and everything. Alpike's useful for the cavs. It depends what type of archers you've got. Like, personally, I always prefer taking my time with the shot, because I get a bit gung ho if
that's why you don't play ranger in it.
I don't play anything anymore.
What do you mean anymore? No, I saw you play something like 2 weeks ago.
Hey, did I?
We'll never know. We'll just leave that in suspense.
Maybe I didn't. We've got eight, I think, now. No.
I do like... Yes, they do have eight, Saracen. So maybe we will go live soon. I do like Norse on this map. Like, it looks very open, but at the same time, where you're going to fight, it's very closed areas. So I do prefer a really good infantry faction.
Do you think Saracens are going to try and bring it straight to an infantry fight?
Well, with Norse, that's what I would do. Especially against Vegas, because their shields cannot take those axes.
Oh, I saw an NL. Maybe that means not live. Oh, something's happening.
Well, are you saying you can't understand Polish? I thought we established this. Just ask Aeronwen. She'll translate for us.
If it's not live now, then, I mean, I'm at 100% record in trying to interpret. Just saying. So,
I'll
get that out there.
Then I'll rely on you then instead.
I mean, it's looking like I was right. Oh, look. There we go. Live.
That could be a Polish word, though. They just said NL.
Yeah, that's good luck. and ready is thank you.
Oh, mate. Okay. Now we're ready. So maybe we'll be going in inside the match finally. Keep in mind, people in the chat, that you can't tweet at us live at the Dolph Gaming Twitter, or tweet at me at the Kohath. Or Aeronwen at Aerotrent. And Fozzy, do you have a Twitter?
No, you can't tweet at me.
You can't tweet at you. Twitter. Okay, well, just send him a message on Steam.
Tweet at the
others. He'll try to reply. All right. Seems like both teams are ready now. Maybe we'll get this show on the road.
They've had a nice warm-up.
Real life.
Yeah. As have we all, Aeronwen. As have we all.
Well, Kohath definitely needed it.
What? Well, yeah. Again, huge thanks to the chat, especially William, for reminding me to unmute my microphone.
Yeah. Polish Eagles have set up with 2 cav, 4 infantry and 2 archers.
And Saracens with Nords, 1 archer, 5 inch, still the 2 cav.
Just kind of what we'd expected.
Yeah, doing my prediction that the Saracens want to focus on those infantry.
Yeah, remember, guys, we're looking to see if Prince or Sebek gets to 100 kills first. They're both on 99. This could be the round, okay?
Yeah, I hope somebody's taking bets.
Yeah.
All right, we see... Both teams just standing, waiting around for flag. No one really want that early engagement. Archers are not even taking shots. They're all just waiting to see how the flag will spawn. All right, flags in favor of... Well, it's between both teams, actually.
Saracens,
it's in the graveyards.
I think they've got their first, yeah.
All right, yeah, they are.
Having their first is a huge advantage.
Especially with those infantry.
Looking quite for Saracens, I think, actually, at the moment.
All right, P just positioning right now. Saracen is coming in with a good bump, taking Blackhawk down to a quarter of herself. No kills yet, though. No one racing flag either. They're just waiting. I think Saracens is making a mistake. They're letting P set up as they see fit.
No, it was a big hit on Blackhawk, though. He's very close to death.
Yeah. Lovka is also down a little bit of health. Well, so is Harmon, though. That's Kev. He's risking a lot, taking these early hits. Alright, P may be wanting to push in here. I see Warhammer advancing a little bit.
Yeah, Prince is supposed to
be. Where's Sebek? I've lost track of him. I'm just watching.
Alright,
P is
pushing in now.
Here we go. Black Hulk getting the first kill. Sebek gets to 100.
Sebek gets played.
Yeah, it's done. Go Sebek.
First round.
Error takes a double kill though. Saracen's hugely winning this fight currently.
Oh,
Prince is very close to death.
Oh, PE taking it back though, getting two kills on Saracens. Matafix, good shot.
Down one. Prince has no.
Prince goes down. Sebek got the 100 first. It's like, I'll take you
it's
out.
It's 3 against 3, but Dictator has raised the flag all along this fight and gets the flag up.
Good play from Saracens there.
Really good. Dictator
they
just.
Were rewarded with the accolade of 100 kills.
Yeah.
Sebek.
Dictator using his awareness, just raising that flag whilst everyone else is busy.
Yeah, we could stop the stream now. We've got.
Yeah, yeah. What's the point of carrying on?
Alright, we see P doing the same, taking the tavern area. Saracens is very split up at the moment, having a few people in their spawn and,
and
the rest of the stairs.
Pushed, I think. Yep, Blackhawk and Co. are pushing at him now. Sebek's come back for support.
Well, I think they're just skirmishing a little bit. I don't think they want to do an actual push.
Yeah, no, they backed off.
Yeah, why don't they want to do an actual push?
Been cagey so far, hasn't it? Well, Blade's in a good position.
Matafix is going.
I'll fix. For the chat, I'll fix the scores during the transition after the first set.
Oh, I forgot that sword.
Oh, I've got mine sorted. How good am I?
Oh,
yes.
Fozzy. Doing good. Alright, flag spawns in the middle.
No,
in favor of Polish Eagle.
Yeah, we'll see if Saracens
Excited to see how Saracens want to push into this. Currently, they seem...
They've just seen what happens if you wait too long, so I'd expect a quick move.
Yeah, but keep in mind, Saracens has that extra infantry, so they want to do a push. They don't want to wait.
Yeah.
Saracens pushing in up through
the
alley.
Around the corner now.
Want to push through that archway. P maybe not wanting to take that fight, backing off a little bit.
Yeah, they left four on this side.
Oh, Gorn taking them in the back right now, splitting them up. Saracens coming in good cavalry work there. P did not see those cavalry coming at all. Harmon gets a triple kill.
Harmon just destroyed them.
Oh wow, unfortunate
team kill. Yeah.
This is a slaughter. In favor of Saracens.
Good play from Voka, is it? There. 3-on-1 with no shield. He lasted for quite some time.
Yeah. I mean, that was an amazing play by Saracens. Having one infantry push him in the back, splitting two of them up, and then the cavalry just hitting them. They were not prepared at all.
Yeah, and this is PE's map, and they got the first faction pick, so I kind of would hope that they...
I think they will make a comeback during the second set, though, with their infantry.
Yeah.
As I mentioned earlier, my opinion is that when you have a really good infantry faction like Nords, you're just going to roll through, really. Especially against Vagars, their shields cannot take those axes.
I mean, Polish Eagles, they've been playing... They've not been aggressive or anything, which I think they'll be forced to be when they're Nords, so that'll be good to see.
I suppose what they want some archers to do some work before they...
Yeah. Their archers weren't set up too great. There was one of them was a bit too close to the archway. I think Blade was at the tavern, which is a good spot.
I think all of PE was out of position there when Saracens pushed.
Yeah.
Flag is on PE in the graveyard.
Alright, let's see how they do it defending the flag in the graveyard. If they can raise it just
Blade
as Dictator
going
did.
Ninja, but decided to change his mind. Get caught out now though.
Saracens quite close, aren't
they? Saracens being allowed to set up as they see fit.
Watches.
Good shot on Carpe Diem.
Oh no, he's got a bit of health. Oh, and he takes out Harmon. That's a big kill actually.
Alright, Saracens seems to wanting to use their infantry pushing through the narrow alley behind the church. Sebek's caught out though. Let's see if Blackhawk can take him. played takes down Kark for DM.
Eagles, Cav, not helping Black Hawk that much there.
They try, but they weren't doing it as successful. Yeah. Saracens now pushing onto the flag.
Yeah, here we go. I think Saracens are gonna.
They're very split up though at the moment. If PE Cav can do some work here, then I think PE can take it. Oh, another unfortunate team kill from PE. Dominique goes down. Warhammer, guns go both down.
He's still alive, but he's going to go down now. I think. Oh, Era comes in to help, actually. They're
four
both
against
very close
four.
To
three against three. It's very close match.
Double kill for Era.
I think Saracens Blue could take this. So Sebek running around without a shield, flaming a little bit. P, he still has that cav up. Oh, now it's two against three.
Yeah,
a bump and Sebek will go down.
Yeah.
So one hit on if Matafix gets one hit, he can start shooting. Oh no, no, no! Wasn't to be.
Sebek, can he do it? Oh no, goes down to blue. Good play by PE there. It was so close, like going down to five against five, four against four, three against three. I like this round.
I think that early kill on Harmon did a lot more damage than they thought.
Still not changing anything up. Both teams running with the exact same lineup.
Harmon did a lot of previous rounds, so yeah, he would have missed this one.
They've been a bit annoyed. He got killed, taken out quite cheaply. Went for the jab hit and just.
I think, even though they're caught out a lot of times, PE is doing a lot of more work as a team. See, Matafix and Arrow just hugely up there with their kills, 6-1 and 6-2, whilst PE has divided them over the team.
Yeah, they seem to be ready to cover the flag if it's on Saracens.
Both teams just camping one flag each. Saracens camping the corner and PE camping the middle one.
Yeah, Prince is way away from that one though, off the other side of the bridge.
Alright, Saracens gets the favour of the flag.
Are you going forward with that?
They've been waiting for that one for a while, haven't they?
Sebek.
Well, Matavix is set up. They don't want to. Oh, Sebek. Maybe
Sebek,
being caught out here.
No, his team's there to support.
Yeah, but P's not really doing anything to scare him away either. Dictator racing that flag like a true champ.
Matavix. Oh, he took a hit there.
Oh, Seba got a support now. Oh,
another
that's
team
a third
kill.
Team kill so that's far from PE.
Oh, Carpe Diem decides, well, I don't like that. I'll even it up. Don't you worry.
It's not even though. It's 7 against 6. Favor of Saracens. Oh, PE evening it out.
Facing two versus one.
Oh.
Oh, nice no. Dictator's left the flag.
Yeah. Well, nice shot from Blade as well. That checks out.
3 against 5 now. Favor of Saracens.
Got the flag as well.
Oh, Vosh goes down. So fortunate. Dominique and Blue both go down.
Oh, Watch takes down Gorn and gets his horse back.
2 against 3. Saracens down 3 up. They got the flag almost up though. Their infantry has to get on it. Oh no. Saracens win the round. Again, Dictator and doing amazing work on that flag work. Would always assume he's in Dolph. Really good set this, I think.
Yeah, and Saracen's taking the set on PE's choice of map.
It was two flag wins though, wasn't it?
Yeah,
I think Polish Eagles waited too long, you know, being that infantry on top, like they were not scaring him away at all. They were just allowing him to just be intimidating. As you said, he was supported by his own infantry, but at the same time, they could have at least pushed him out instead of just allowing him to be there.
Yeah.
No whisper target found.
That would be remarkably fast.
Yeah. Well, they got time to make up.
That's true.
Yeah, PE now being Norse, the stronger infantry faction, at least by favoritism. I think they'll do better on this set. Maybe deploying the tactic that Saracens did, is that leave one infantry on the flag whilst the rest is just occupying the Saracens.
Yeah, I think with the quality of the two teams, whoever's playing more aggressive, I think, is going to do better, just because of the sort of momentum that you can have if you're going a lot more aggressively. But hey, we'll see. This brand will tell us all.
Yeah, we're just waiting for the teams to go live right now. Who was it that breached the 100 mark? Remind me, please.
Sebek.
All right, props to him.
Although I have to say, Matafix was making a real surge to try and get there before anyone else wanted it. Unfortunately, the deficit was too much to make up.
Yeah, 11 would have been quite a lot.
Quite doable though. Doing good work in the set. Let's talk a little bit about more like PE. Most of the time, in my opinion, we're caught out of position, you know, just delaying, not really focusing on the flag.
They seemed really hesitant. They did. They weren't coming across as sort of like they were striking forwards, pushing strongly. You're right, and they got out a few times.
Yeah, for example, taking the...
particularly, a lot of damage.
Yeah, for example, taking the second round where the flag spawned in the middle, they were just allowing themselves to be flanked by the Saracens, both by cavalry and infantry. All right, we are not live.
It's not live. Yeah, not live.
Almost. So maybe this will be a repeat from the Polish Cup 2014, where Saracens beat PE.
I mean, they did. They did win earlier on in the competition, didn't they?
Yes, they did. Winning. 8-6,
yeah.
In the early stages of the league stage. I don't know, but it's such a strong number as well. 3-1 is such an advantage going forward. If they can pull it off as well in this winning 3-0 or 3-1, then Saracens are pretty much set. Just having to win a few rounds for the victory.
Well, I'm hoping this will spur Polish Eagles into the... playing a bit more aggressively, a bit more purpose.
Definitely, they have the skills, like their people can do it. They just gotta get the confidence there. However, PE is missing Hubert, one of their strongest players. Unless he's playing under a different name.
I think what it is, I know I keep going on about the 100 kills, but I think they were so demoralised that Prince didn't get the 100 first, that they've taken a little while to come to terms with the fact that accolade will not be there this year.
Yeah.
And now they've had a bit of a moment to just process the fact that Sebek was able to do it. They'll come back fighting.
Well, we still don't know who's going to have the most kills for the tournament. Maybe Prince will take that one.
All right. Just been informed that we're going live. Saracens starting as Vegas, Polish Eagle as Norwich. Let's see how this goes. All right. First up, Polish Eagles starting with 4 infantry, 5 infantry, 2 cav, 1 archer, doing the same as Saracens did, whilst... it's just a mirror
Saracens
match.
Are doing,
yeah.
Saracens are
doing 4 infantry, 2 cavalry, and 2 rangers.
Almost as if they're all doing the standard sort of loadouts for this map and these factions.
Just been told by Erminus that Hubert might be Warhammer. Mate. Like he said, don't quote me on it. But if that's the case, then...
what you immediately did was quoted him on the stream. That...
yes. Exactly like he wanted it.
That's a quote from Aminus 2016. You're all welcome.
Exactly. All right, just to recap.
Everyone's
first set
everyone's
ended
3-1. Their own flags.
Yeah, just as per usual. First set ended 3-1 in favor of Saracens. Let's see if P can take it up.
Flag in the graveyard again, right under
Saracens'
feet.
All right, if Saracens can get on it earlier, they can start raising it. Arrows seem to be
straight down the middle.
Missing about a little bit. all of the Saracens is currently in the graveyard, just waiting for the PE.
Oh, wow.
Around the other side of the church.
Dominique may be being caught out here. Oh no, he ran through them easily.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Warhammer, maybe Hubert, but definitely calling themselves Warhammer has just gone down.
That's unfortunate for PE. That'll be a huge loss. Vosh is taken down to half health as well. Sebek raising that flag like a champion.
Over halfway now, yeah, almost two
thirds. He's got to make a pressure soon.
Prince has had enough. Yeah. He's like, I'm going on my own. Screw you all. I'll do it on my own if I need to. I want those kills.
P Cav coming in, but I'm doing a lot of work here. I think Saracen's infantry just having fun with them.
A lot of damage.
Oh, fortunate
Prince
team kill on Prince.
He was like, you'll get no kills. Don't go in without the team.
Exactly. Don't go in without the team. You'll go down. Saracen's cleaning up right now. 5 against 4.
Good solid kill on Sebek there in a 2 versus 1.
PE might still pick it up though. Double kill. Kramer doing heavy work for PE here. Oh, it's 4 against 3 now. Can PE get it back? Saracens has left the flag. Being a bit more defensive now. Oh, blue goes down.
Very close to death. Kramer. Not been able to find the shield.
Blade goes down, 2 against 3 now. Oh, arrow goes down, 2 against 2. This is close.
Kramer has had a round and a half.
Can Harmon carry Saracens to victory? If he can just get 3 seconds on the flag, they can make a tie.
Kramer has no health.
You just got to get to the flag if he's aware of his surroundings.
Lost his shield.
Oh, yeah. It's
Kramer
too late.
Kramer has no health, but what he has is a vengeance. He got something like 5 kills. There we go. Look at that. Brilliant.
Poor scouting, in my opinion. If he had seen the flag, because the Saracens had the flag up there for the last time, and he could have made it a tie.
Yeah.
PE taking up the first round.
Not a convincing start from them to the round, if I'm honest. There's a few team kills, a few early avoidable deaths. But
definitely,
they gotta thank Kramer for that because he was in the thick of it. Took a lot of health damage at the beginning as well, but like an angry berserker, he just carried on going.
Prince learning his lesson: don't push without the team, or I'll team kill you.
Or the team will kill him. Yes. Oh, we've had confirmation. Sigis is Hubert, I think. Sigis has said that Hubert is Warhammer even.
Alright, according to Sigis, that's the case, but let's not quote him on that, even though we just did.
Yeah, even though we just did. Let's not quote anybody. We don't quote here.
Exactly.
When we do. Yeah.
Alright, flag spawning in favor of Saracens. However, they don't seem to want you to go on the flag. They're very defensive right now.
PE are following them down to that corner, that's why.
Saracens wanting to fight them here, it seems.
Prince thought about going around the corner, remembered the last time he pushed on his own and it's gone the other way.
Oh, Lofka might be caught out here. Nah.
Is that an L or an I?
I'm assuming it's an L.
Lofka. I think it's an I.
I think it's an I. Yeah.
Alright, then let's treat it as an A.
We'll call him that one.
Both teams now advancing on the flag. PE with our strong infantry. Let's see if they can push into Saracens here. So remember that Saracens have been doing better cab work so far.
Yes, and I'm waiting anxiously to see where they're going to come from.
Blackhawk goes down, Dominic coming in, couching in.
Matapik's lovely shot, Blue.
Saracens cleaning up.
Kramer goes down. His heroics from the last round will not be repeated.
Oh, another fortunate team kill by PE.
A lot of team kills from PE, and it's costing them, it really is.
PE now getting a few kills, but I think it's too late, it's 4 against 2 right now. Both Virus and the Offguard gets a double kill.
Just desperately throwing his jabs, they're not going anywhere.
Yeah, they're just trying to raise that flag 30 seconds off. Let's see if he can pull this back, or maybe he'll just try to survive. Save his equipment.
Definitely not hiding behind the corner, guys. They never.
Oh no!
Oh, unfortunate!
Virus taking down Dominic!
Virus saw his moment to
and now Yofka's done. You know, I'm just gonna save my equipment, save that money up. Yeah. It's a good tactic. Virus screwing up his team, but as you said earlier, there's been a lot of team kills from PE. think that they might have not been as prepared as they should have been. Maybe not done the warm-ups. You know, jumps and push-ups. Got to stretch those legs.
But out of character, I wouldn't class B as a team that just team kill to this degree. There are some teams that you can sort of rely on them
definitely
killing a little bit during the matches. But yeah, it's for a final. Maybe nerves. I don't know.
Maybe yeah, and I was saying that they're the team that have been playing together, whereas the Saracens have been more or less split up.
Yeah, but Saracens' characters have been very active though over in the scene. Like, even though they're not been playing with each other,
killing.
They're still very used to playing Warband, you know, playing as a team. It doesn't matter who you're playing with, as long as you're used to playing as that team.
Well, I think, yeah, the way your team reacts, it does matter if you're used to playing with the same people.
Well, of course. It's easier.
And hopefully you wouldn't team kill so much.
Yeah, you'd think you would team kill them as much, yeah.
Alright, P just favouring the river right now. Saracens taking the grave spawn. And they get the flag again. Let's see if PE can do what they did the fourth round here. I'm sorry, the first round. My bad.
Yeah, well, let's hopefully see a bit more of a better push.
Can Prince push in again alone?
Yes, and take the sacrifice. Yovka on the left.
No, Warhammer goes down again. Wasn't he the first one that went down the other round as well by a couch? And now P
is
caught behind the church.
They were on their own there. They're just stuck in this back bit. Oh.
Oh, Bayovka. Doing good work.
Yovka kills him.
And that did work out for them.
Three against five.
That was clearly his plan all along.
Blaze struggling a little bit with the Serenade cavalry. Both are Saracen's cavalry. Oh, my bad. P taking on two of them. There's only Harmon left.
Yeah,
they tried one-man army.
We saw their PE struggling behind the church, but an unfortunate team kill from Saracens and just good infantry play by Yovka got them that fight. Really tearing apart the Saracens.
I didn't see Prince die, but I'm going to assume he charged in on his own and he was team killed for his lack of team spirit. Oh, Harmon versus Blue. With Blade actually coming to help.
Yeah, but Blade's really look off like a bump will kill him probably. Harmon, do not want to engage there. I think he can take Blue head on.
Go on, Harmon, charge the flag.
do a Prince. Oh, Blue taking a hit.
I think this is just gonna. Neither of them will go down.
I think Blue will get dismounted. Oh no, Harmon disengaging. Oh. I was hoping an early engagement against Black Oak there, but.
So, Polish Eagles close to evening it up. It could be 4-4 going into the next map, which would be good.
That'd be really tense. Of course, the next map is Saracen's map, so they are the favourites there. 3-4 currently, Saracens to PE.
They the favourites there, like they were the favourites to. Like PE were the favourites to win. Or your favourite.
Well, it's not over yet. Saracens crossing the bridge, taking the tavern, as we have seen as on every round so far. Both teams not wanting that early engagement, just waiting for flag. And then setting up.
We haven't set up for that flag back there, though. They've pushed quite forward.
Oh, it's
and
in the middle.
In center.
Which one? The Saracens?
Flag is in center.
Saracens not leaving the tavern like they... Just as they did in the other round. P... Very split up right now. If Saracens can make a push, maybe we can get that early kill.
Yeah, P planning to chase them around to the flag, but Saracens not going.
But that's a very open position, Saracens. Saracens Kev can do work there. Oh!
Oh, error drops.
That's unfortunate for Saracens. That might cost them the round, actually.
To the Warband gods. And
oh.
Gorn has done the same with Carpe Diem.
Getting a headshot on Carpe Diem.
Not a good round for Saracens.
Two down for Saracens. However, they did take off Vosges.
Big kill. Your
Massifix goes down to Yovka.
Sebek goes down. Harmon gets a kill.
Six against
Blue
three right now. Saracens might be evening out though, 3 against 5.
Gorn with no health whatsoever is charging and dies.
Off to
Prince just desperately going, team, hello, guys, hello, anyone, hello?
Being very wounded, Princess. Oh, virus goes down. Good work by Yofka. I'm impressed by Yofka so far.
This is why I have the big armor.
Yofka 9-0, dude. I'm really liking him this set.
Unfortunate kill, unfortunate drop for Saracen.
Yeah, definitely costing the round. And the first map is concluded 4-4. An even tie. It's amazing. Just shows how close these teams are. In terms of skills.
Also shows how useful it is to be Nords on this map.
Also, but yeah. Do keep in mind that team kill and that drop did do a lot of work
that,
for Polish
that
Eagles.
Was disappointing, yeah. Oh, this map.
Going
right.
Into the second map is River Village
yes.
With Serenids versus Vegas.
Also, as it's known of. Ah,
yeah,
that one.
That's fuzzy. Sorry, we talked through that. So Saracens was picked by Saracens and Swede was picked by PE for this map. And the map was chosen by Saracens.
I was about to say Saracens, what?
Saracens.
Vegas.
Right, no, they've changed it to the Saracens.
They heard me.
Yeah, they were like, oh, whoops. Mistakes were made.
Let's see if they can stay in game this time. Talking about the disconnect from the last set.
Yeah, that was just so harsh. We don't want any more disconnects, guys.
It was also right before the fight. It was so unfortunate for Saracens.
And the team killed.
Maybe it was a ploy all along from PE. Well,
I think what happened was the Saracens said, we need to win this round. We must sacrifice the gods of Warband. And they were like, right, okay. Turn off the modem whilst the others thought, well, human sacrifice will do, our team kill.
But yeah, I mean,
communication there,
but
the sacrifice.
It didn't work in when they killed Prince, so they should have known that it didn't work now as well.
Yeah.
I didn't think Prince was sacrificed. I thought he was executed for failure, failure to stick.
Well,
with the team.
It depends how you look at it. Because keep in mind, his team didn't follow us in quite. They were like, "Yeah, you can just
his
go
team
die.
Win,
it's fine."
Yeah. Yeah. It's not always helpful when somebody says, "Right, charge," and only one person does.
Yeah. It's like, guys, hello.
Talking about what we did earlier, Sebek breaching that 100 goal. I'm still amazed at how many kills they've got. Also, both teams crossing that 600 mark, and Polish Eagles probably crossed 700 now.
Yeah, I think so. Thanks to
do team kills count as a
Kramer.
Dude, Yofka, I keep saying it, but Yofka, I'm so amazed by his play last set. Getting 9-0 in score.
Yeah.
I think
despite
at least behind
many attempts by his teammates to try and team kill everyone on their team, he was able to survive and live the charmed life.
At least behind
the
church. I think it was the first round or the second round. He did so well
second
surviving.
One, yeah.
Oh yeah, when it was him and a calf, was it pushing?
Yeah,
four.
Watch charged round to try and come to his aid and got killed. But it did give Yovaka even the time to avenge him.
Definitely.
It's always the ones with the difficult names that do well. It's so annoying.
Maybe we should just look at their faces, like, okay, the one with the mustache. The one with the beard.
Oh, he doesn't have a beard.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Does he have a dimple, maybe? Or blue eyes?
The one with the beard is... I'm looking at their faces. That's about 9 of the people currently playing. Maybe even more. Was this live? Yes, it is.
It is live.
It is.
Alright, let's see how this is going to turn up. Saracens taking 4 cav and 3 archers and 1 infantry, whilst P's taking 3 cav, 3 infantry, 2 rangers.
Oh, I'm looking forward to this one. So it's going to be just a rain of arrows.
I personally prefer Saracens' approach on this. 4 cav, just putting that cav process out there because it's such an open map.
They've done giving the archers lances.
As we said earlier, first map has concluded 4-4, so it's an even tie. So this map decides it all, hopefully. Unless we get another tie, which would be so much fun.
Yeah, I always love that, and they've got Winterberg as the tiebreaker.
I've still not seen that one in a match, so I want a draw. Yeah, every time it comes close to a draw, and every time I'm like, oh, I've not seen that one, and as soon as I mention that, someone just dominates, and it's like, oh, I'm sorry, everybody, that's my fault there. Era's got a lovely position to shoot from, but PE just bodies on the flag.
Yeah, PE with that strong infantry presence, getting flag early really benefits them.
So yeah, they went straight out there and the flag fell at their feet.
Yeah, it all depends on the Saracens cav, how well they can make a push here. But
Error.
Dictator being the lone infantry for Saracens, gotta make that push.
Oh, he's going for it. He's like, I will kill them all, team.
PE almost got the flag up though, mind you. It's like 5 more seconds and it's up.
Yeah, Dictator's gotta do his look at this, in the middle.
Flag's raising though, yeah. PE gets it. Saracens taking too long to make that presence known. No kills from either team. It was just PE dominating the flag. Saracens not being able to make that push.
That's the downside, of course, if you've got 4 cav and 3 archers and the flag's in that little corner bit there and the other team have alpikes, is, you know, you don't want to push, so.
PE going straight to the village flag.
Hoping for all the closed ones. They've seen the class set up and they're like, oh, keep it closed. We can.
But well, mind you, even though
Carpe Diem was like, brave. Oh, I'm going to come, no, never mind. Regretting many life decisions, but he's made it out alive, minus half his health.
Mind you, even though this flag is very close to the village, it's still very open for rangers. They can do a lot of work here if P isn't careful. Saracens just waiting for that flag, setting up in favor of the outer flag one.
Yeah,
Carpe Diem's got as far away from them as he possibly can now.
Saracens get the flag spawn.
Yeah, flag's at Saracen's spot. So.
Now it's up to P to make that coordinated push.
Yeah.
Saracen's setting up though that major crossfire. Era,
actually.
Oh, they will.
On the river side.
Three cav. Going for Era. He's not
come
got
to save him.
And has got stuck.
Oh, Warhammer, risky maneuver here, trying to take error in the riverbed.
It's all of the Saracen cav just driven them away now. Blue decides he'd like to crash into a tree, but he's distracted.
Oh, good shot by Blade. P, gotta stick together here. Saracen's cav might pick them off if they split up.
Dictator's coming in now. Oh, takes out Prince's shield.
Gotta use that Tillicky, gotta scout behind you.
Yeah, Blackhawk should have stopped that cav there, to be honest.
Definitely, or someone should have called it out. Harmon stopped.
Just riding through, Warhammer goes down.
Matovic's being chased by Yofka right now in the graveyard. Graveyard,
Zebek
actually.
Coming in again. Blackhawk.
6-6 currently.
6-6, yeah.
Evening out.
He has been taking more damage, though, as we can see on their character screens.
Oh, Zebek
goes down. Zebek
down.
Good shot
double
by Prince.
Crossbow hit, I think. Armin's close to death.
Armin trying to take up Prince? No, he decides not to. PE got their presence on the flag right now.
Error is actually in a crossfire right now. I don't think he realizes it. I don't think Prince realizes it either.
Virus coming in with that lance.
Oh, it's got to go down on the flag.
Ooh.
Dictator close to death and goes down. Virus putting in a shift here. Blackhawk double kill.
Sars to the rest of Sars.
Oh, Virus, very good.
An archer with a lance, dude. Nothing scarier.
Matterfix.
Good kills by Kramer.
He missed quite a lot in there. Could have been a difference there. But got to be. So, good Polish effort Eagles, 6-4 by Polish Eagles.
I'm still amazed because
someone said they wanted to see Winterberg, and that's just
But I'm still amazed how they managed to get that flag. Like their infantry just pushed in, and Saracens was like, "No, you can have the flag. It's fine."
Well, yeah, they tried to do the crossfire, but and charge in with their camp.
Yeah, but he did so well though. Like having one cav on their river archer, and then Iofka chasing down the one in the grapevines.
I can see Saracens even have taken an extra infantry now.
Yeah,
so they've clearly decided.
Couldn't hold that flag, could he, against?
Yeah, PE again hoping for the windmill flag. Oh, yeah, Saracens pushing up though.
Setting up on the flags and saying, come at me.
However, Saracens are very split up right now. Like, they're pushing on to the windmill flag, but. For example, Virus is like way
like
off.
Gonna go in on his own, then.
Dictator
way
off as well.
Don't think PE have quite realised.
It's interesting how the flag spawned though.
Yeah, miles away. Yeah.
Both teams just waiting
looks
to see
like
what the other ones are doing.
Yeah, I don't think Saracens have realised. Now they have.
Oh, but look at Blade though, turning his back.
Wodge is coming up behind everybody actually, but oh, he's been seen by Gorn.
Warhammer chasing down Carpedium. He's chasing off.
Metafix staying on the hill, shooting PE in the back.
PE seems very scared of Saracens right now, allowing Saracens to do exactly what they want.
They're drawing them away, but Blue is on the flag. I don't know how long he's going to remain unnoticed.
Oh, I didn't notice that. Good spot.
Carpedium
chasing him off. PE going back towards their spawn to take the flag from there. Mind you, there's only 1 minute 8 seconds left of the round.
Yeah, I think they might actually beat him in the race to get there. Oh, Carpe Diem's horse goes down, and he's very close to going down. Got double teamed by Warhammer and Blue.
Blue, though, not able to finish him off.
There you go, Saracens made it to the flag.
Bush trying to take down Virus.
Fantasy has been left behind, though.
Yeah, to shoot him from behind.
To be fair.
Right, now the P infantry's making themselves known.
Oh, Prince takes out Error.
Oh, good shot by Virus there, taking out Blue as he was coming in.
Virus getting pushed by Black Hook though, he's not getting the support from Matafix actually, but oh, here we go. Harmon comes in to try and help, but...
P infantry again doing so much work. Saracen's cav is not that promising as we see them the last map. They're really faltering to the PE infantry here. Matafix being the only one left alive for Saracens.
He was hidden over at the back.
Oh, goes down to Blade.
Very good.
Good shot by Blade. I mean, that was a risky shot, though. A lot of their teammates in there. Just like,
risky,
I want that
greedy
kill. Really good effort by PE here. That's a clean sweep.
I think Saracens made the wrong classes there. I think they did something fundamentally wrong. They backed off. They let PE just stick people on the flags. And the one time they tried to get on the flag, which was that last round, they just, even, you know, just PE just charged in and they lost the fight.
Currently 7-4 in favor of PE going on to the fourth
set. Gotta
see
something special from Saracens.
They do have the quote-unquote stronger faction now, though, this Wadio.
The Saracens playing as Saracens. Oh no, they're not. I've not switched the teams. Never mind.
Good job.
That to be like, right, you know, you'd expect something good, but no, the Saracens playing as Swadia.
Yay, crossbows.
Yeah, they've got that.
I really hope, As you said, Fozzy, that it'll become to a tie. Saracens taking that 3-0, making it 7-7.
I don't know if it will. It was quite a convincing display from PE.
Definitely. Their infantry is doing so much work, and Saracens cavalry, like as I said, we saw them very good presence on the first map. However, they have not been able to show that on this one as well. For example, when PE infantry is going alone against one of the rangers, their cav cannot stop him.
Yeah. I mean, it is worth pointing out again, though, that Saracens did win against PE in the earlier rounds, so maybe they know something that we don't.
Earlier in the league, you mean?
Yeah.
Close, though, wasn't it? Did you say 8-6?
It was 8-6.
That's correct. Looking on the Polish Eagle league stage here, they won. Well, they lost 6-8 to Saracens. However, it was pretty early in the league. So maybe P is like, okay, we learned from this mistake and we're not going to repeat it. I think that's more convincing argument.
Yeah, also I think the Polish Cup started while WMT was still going on. They might have been a bit busy as well.
Polish Eagles ready.
As you said earlier, when that P has been sticking together a lot while Saracens has been fighting all over the place, maybe that's starting to show here. That on the open map where their infantry is so much important, like their teamwork, that is really coming through.
I don't know. I just think they just made the wrong classes, and they didn't do the right thing. You know, they tried to back off and crossfire. They sort of lost track of the flag, I think, is what happened.
In my opinion, though,
they were just too late, weren't they?
Yeah, and I mean, to be fair, in the second one as well, Matafix missed a few key shots, not to pick him out, which I just did. But you know, if he'd been able to do that, which, you know, I'm sure he was trying, obviously, it might have changed it. Although, to be fair, it was 2-4 or something then.
All right, going live, the fourth and hopefully final set. PE starting off 7-4 against Saracens. It's quite interesting. We see Saracens starting with 4 cav, 2 infantry, 2 rangers, and PE doing the same as they did the last set. 3 cav, 3 infantry, and 2 rangers.
I've clearly decided they're just going to sit on the flag.
If this it works, why change it?
Yeah, well, this is the class set up that Saracen had for the final round, wasn't it? I think they put an extra in, so...
Yeah.
Saracen's gone straight up to win real flag, and PE are coming.
PE showing that we won't let you have this alone. Blackhawk, of course.
Don't get quite as lucky as PE did, yeah.
PE, Blackhawk running without shoes, as per usual. Now, what's a few pebbles and grass between your toes? Saracens, though, pushing straight to flag. We saw last round.
Are you going to try and cut them off?
Yeah, we saw last round, like, Saracens, when this was mirrored, where PE was so dominant on the Saracens. However, the PE just wanna back off now. Go to flag, hold it, doing their good tactics.
Yeah. Era's getting a bit ahead of everyone else. Ah, the Blade's in a nice little slot here.
Now it's basically which Rangers can set up first.
Yeah.
Saracens Dominique coming in. Being able to pull someone off though. Virus staying across the river, getting some hits on Warhammer.
Warhammer does know he's there, which...
Yeah, it means Virus has got to keep his eye on.
Now we're fighting on flag, PE having one more infantry. Sebek, good bump on
Sebek
Kramer.
Comes in, yeah, good bump. Matafix shooting in as well.
Oh, another hit on Kramer.
Black
and Carpe Diem goes down.
Kramer goes down.
Very even right now, 6 against 7.
Double kill for Lodge.
Error. Oh, nice hit from Matafix there. An error take
triple
out of Black
kill Hawk. For Lodge.
Doing really good, but both teams so close. 5 against 5 right now. So if PE takes a kill, Saracens takes a kill. You know, they're not going to allow him to take an advantage.
Thanks, Dan. Error.
Oh,
so
unfortunate team kill by Vosh, though. Lugus dismounted.
So that's his fourth kill in this round.
Really Blade gets a double kill.
Oh, Sebek.
Saracens, two people left. Very can good. They pull it back? No, Vosh gets a double kill.
Now,
really?
I have seen Virus kill 7 of the opposing team when he was the only one left, so...
He's got no health at all, though. Oh, wow, he survives the hit. I'm going for Watch with a Vengeance here.
Bush goes down. It's a really good effort by Bush though this set, this round, getting 4 kills.
So that's 8-4.
You got
that
5.
That is a victory for Polish Eagles. Harrow will still stream the last rounds, but this has got to discourage Saracens. Unless PE decides, okay, we won, just do your own thing now.
Wasn't this Saracen's map?
It was. So it's so surprising that PE got 4 rounds so far. No changes in classes yet, and both teams basically doing the same, both just pushing towards the windmill. I like this rule set better, where it's the same as the WMT. You know, wait until 2 minutes and then the flag spawns. Gives both teams a chance to
set up. Especially on the bigger maps, yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, I think that Saracen's
just
level.
Not getting the flag. I think it's going to fight here, though.
PE, though, just waiting for Saracens. Oh, no, now they're backing off.
Yeah.
Saracens, good couch. The off-guard loses his shield.
Misses it.
Oh, blue goes down. Arrow goes down. Vorsch again doing good work as cavalry.
Carpe Diem comes in, misses couch on blade.
They've had so many team kills this match, but they've been doing amazing though. It's like, yeah, I'll team kill you, but I'll get a double kill for it. Double kill from Black Hawk, by the way. Saracens 3 left against the 5 Polish Eagles.
That's a fix. Good hits on Black Hawk. Prince shooting in as well.
Harmon got some work done. He's just hanging in the back right now. Oh, Matterfix takes down Black Hawk. No one on flag yet, so it's just a matter of who kills who in there.
Just duking it out now.
3 against 2.
Matterfix, if he can hit one, he'll kill him.
Prince going for flag though. 45 seconds left.
He didn't get the memo. Never mind the rounds, it's all about kills now.
Yeah.
If he gets the most kills.
Bush. Trying to take that Matterfix. Good hits. No, Kramer comes in and steals the kill from Woosh. Currently 9-4 to Polish Eagles.
Prince wasn't even going for the kills there. He was like, if I can't have 100, I won't go.
Well, he has got over his 100 now.
He has got over 100, but he didn't win the award. There we go, Saracens. That's what you... At least Sebek got to 100 first. That's the consolation.
Saracens doing what they did the first, the third set. Taking down one infantry in favor of a ranger. Trying to get those last 3 rounds, maybe, for a more even score.
Yeah, both teams going to
Oh, the off guard goes down. Strong infantry for PE down there. Oh no, Morgan Saracens Carmen are just pushing right now.
Harmon comes in.
Arrow being caught out. Gorm just pushing in wildly.
Oof, big hit from Wodge on Harmon. That long Alpike on the.
Arrow goes down.
Arrow goes down,
it's currently 7 against 7. Sebek goes down. Dominique. Oh, wow. Another one!
Another team. Honestly, I'm starting to think PE are doing this on purpose now.
What you mentioned before about a sacrifice, I think this is it. You know, kill a teammate, win the round.
Out. Yes.
You of course had enough.
Watch was in a 2 versus 1 for Cav there for quite some time. He did a really good job that goes down.
Matterfix and Carpe Diem, the only one left from Saracens.
Okay, so yeah, it's looking like the teams have decided.
Carpe Diem running off to flag. Oh no, maybe taking the fight to Warhammer. Guess this mounter though.
Gets his vengeance. Like, that's for my
Can
horse.
He get the round back? Can we get another 3 rounds now that people have left? Yeah. Oh. Carpe diem goes down. Huge congratulations to PE winning 10-4 against Saracens.
Bit of a slow start, but they, once they got started, they didn't slow down.
So I think this is the seventh Polish Cup. So, seventh Polish Cup winners. And this is their second gold.
That's correct.
Yeah, they've got the full set. Well, bronze, silver and gold already. So now they're going round again.
Yeah.
Amazing work with Polish Eagle, where we saw them in the league stage. They lost against Saracens 6-8 and they were like, no, we're not having it. We've learned from this. We're going to take it back. And they did. Winning 10-4. Such an impressive score.
Got to be disappointing for Saracens to just get thoroughly demolished on their map.
Definitely.
Yeah, and you know, having won against PE earlier in the tournament, they may well have had a lot of confidence going into this match.
They started very well.
They did.
It was the second map. You know, coming into the second map, it was 4-4. We couldn't call who it was going to be, but yeah.
In all honesty, I think it was more the second set where we saw PE winning 3-1. You know, the first set was just a warm-up round for PE. Like, okay, now we're warmed up. Now we're going to beat you up. And they did. All right, we have a few people for an interview.
Before while they're coming in, let's just say everybody remember to like the channel. Click the little heart or whatever it is these days.
Whatever it is these days, indeed.
Yeah.
Click that follow button. Make sure you also follow us on Twitch, Twitter. You know, keep up to date with the latest off streams. Also, huge thanks again for Dictator for providing the images for this stream.
Yeah, user was moved to your channel.
All right, I guess user coming in right now.
Channel. User was moved to your channel.
Hello, Prince,
Hi.
Warhammer, and Blackhawk. Congratulations with the win.
Yeah, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So how did you feel after the first set where you lost 3-1? Was that when you all thought, all right, this is the comeback, we gotta do this?
No, we were still confident in the game because Nods were stronger faction.
Yeah.
And we're sure we'll come back.
And you did, winning 3-1 second set. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's pretty nice feeling. Saracens are still a very good team to play, and it's difficult to play against them.
So tell me, how were your thoughts before coming into this? Did you expect to win, or was it
user was moved
you,
to your
you
channel.
Thought yourself the underdog? And welcome to Voice as well now.
Yo!
So did you think that you were able to beat them before you went into the match?
Yeah, we were pretty sure we would win.
Yeah, we had a really good year. We were second in WMT. We were second in SNL, so we had our thoughts that we can win this cup and finish a year, which was the best for us actually in our history.
Yeah,
so we were very confident.
Good, taking up the second gold in the Polish Cup.
Yeah, we are very glad to do it. We wouldn't do it without a lot of players who agreed to play with us today. Even Voy, who came now to the channel.
Alright, talking about that, which one do you think the most valuable player on your team was for this match?
Gancho.
Each player was very important, but Prince for sure in the whole tournament.
It was sick.
And Voy probably.
Warhammer. We have to say that this server was totally crap, guys.
Yeah, hard to play.
Is that the reason for the team killed? Yeah, the server.
Yeah. it was sad to play on something like that.
Prince, when you went into this, were you looking at that 100 kill mark that you and Sebek, you were both on 100 kills coming into this? Don't know if you know.
Both on 99.
Yeah, whoever got the first kill would have got 100 kills first in the tournament. I don't know if you're aware of this.
Dictator was writing to me about that, but
yeah.
I never, you know, care about stats or frags. And Archer, it's normal that I've got more kills than the rest of team, so yeah.
Very confident. Starting the second map, the third set, where you won 3-0, was that the point where you knew, okay, now we won either way? Or did you take the fourth set as seriously? Because you wanted that last round.
Actually, we didn't have any tactics. I mean, I wasn't thinking about it. So we were just standing at one place. And River Village is a map where you can actually, you know, make it work. And yeah, it is pretty unfair because the team who has better flags will probably win and can, you know, just sit there and defend yourself.
Definitely, but I think you did really well though with your loadout, with three infantry, three cavalry. Just being able to camp that flag, have your infantry presence there. I think that was really valuable and good tactics.
Yeah, we shouldn't. I mean, we didn't try to push the archers. We were more focused to stay as one group. Only, I guess, single. It was Wolfs, I guess. He was only the man who was tended to catch some archers, but. Our team's main goal was to stay alive on flags and yeah, some clutch shots from archers. Their cuffs wasn't so important on open map. I think it worked pretty fine for us.
Definitely.
Well, you've won, so yes.
Aeronwen, Fozzy, anything more to add?
I had a question, but I've forgotten it now. How bad's that?
Oh, that's pretty bad. Aeronwen?
I know.
No, not really. I mean, just really congratulations. And like you
yes,
said,
indeed.
Silver in WMT and gold in Polish Cup. That's quite good going.
It's been a good few months, hey guys?
By the way, I want to dedicate this win for Colonel Kurtz, our best cav on WMT.
And thank you for streaming and promoting this match, that whole tournament.
No problem. Again, huge congratulations with the win. And with that said, we're cutting the stream there. So thank you everyone for watching and make sure you hit that follow button. Take care.
Yeah.